Okay, I move, 1,490,205.
Second.
All right, we'll let you go back uninterrupted, please, to the questions.
So, municipal sanitation, wastewater treatment, question A, what constitutes the 4.9% increase in the wage account? That goes back to the original answer I had to the question, Jerry, about the other accounts, that those are all union contracts and.
They are.
Step increases.
They're all CBA jobbers?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Item B, seasonal and part-time wages, how many hours and over what period of time and at what rate of pay is this just for summer? It's 1063 an hour, 40 hours a week, 13 weeks, and yes, it is just for the summer.
Good.
C, engineering services budgeted to 10,000 in 2014.
What were the tasks, Keith? Explain the tasks.
That would be mowing the lawns, weed whacking, scrubbing the tanks, cleaning and painting.
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 Okay, so I thought.
C, engineering services budgeted 10,000 in 2014, spent 1750 through September. Explain, please. This is a general account that we use for consultant services as needed. It is necessary. We got lucky this year that between Mike's area of expertise and Chris and my own, we have not needed to hire an engineer other than for that amount there, but that we've spent.
Do you project any needs in this area for 15?
I think, yes. I think next year is going to be a challenging year because we haven't been able to invest in some of our infrastructure improvements, which means that we're going to have to get some outside consultants to come in to help us to kind of piece things together.
Yeah, you spent almost $9,000 in 2013.
Right, that's what I'm saying. That's a general consulting account that we need to have available. If we have a process control problem that, you know, we have in high pHs or BODs or whatever, it gives us the flexibility to hire like Wright Pierce engineers to come in and provide some limited consulting services.
Spent $31,011 and $12,912, so I guess it is in line.
And there is another project that I have in mind for the blower aeration building.
Oh, yeah.
About tying that into the emergency generator.
Oh.
Have an electrical engineer to figure that out.
But you got four blowers in that room, right?
Three blowers.
You should got one shut down, or did you have four?
No, there's a future spot for a four.
Okay, so you got three blowers in there, and what are you doing again?
Blowing air into the tanks up on the hill.
Yeah, aeration.
Yeah.
So what were you going to do?
That whole building is not tied into the emergency generator.
Oh, okay. Tie it up to the emergency generator.
That makes sense.
Okay. What else?
The explained plan for staff development for 2015. That's really just ongoing education for CEUs that the licensed operators need to have. To do the job, they have to every year they have to have continuing education credits.
Right.
E, tipping fees for information purposes. How many hours a day is the press running? Are we running all six cylinders?
Yeah.
Yes, we are using all six cylinders.
How many hours a day are you running, Mike?
This month it's averaging eight.
That's what I figured.
Nine hours a day.
Because there's 254 tons a month is what you're talking about. So that works out to eight or 9 hours a day.
Yeah.
Now, so what are your utilization rate then is?
It's from year to date is 38%.
Year to date. So, yeah. As I recall, it was like, it reached 40% or 42% in the summer.
Yeah.
But it dropped to 35%, yeah. All right, okay, that was information, and so we're running around a 30% plus utilization on that press. How is it working?
Great.
Stainless steel, strong back end.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
F, supplies, $100,000. The 2014 budget dollars were tight for supplies. When one looks at 2011, 12, and 13, actuals which averaged 101. What is the supply status level at this time?
Yeah, that is to say, how you fit for supplies going into next year, or are you really going to need to?
Yeah, I think we've spent $86,000 so far.
Yeah, and you're looking to spend the same.
Yeah.
Okay.
G, gasoline and diesel.
Now, we've talked about that.
Yeah. H, chemicals looks a bit high when one looks back on the actuals.
We have been optimizing our pumps and for the chlorine and the bisulfite usage, so it has been down a little bit.
Has chlorine gone up in cost, Mike? Or
no, it actually went down a little bit.
So what's the big chemicals, Mike?
Well, we have the chlorine, the sodium bisulfite, and then the polymer that
the
we
polymer,
use to,
yeah,
to water the sludge.
So what are you asking for this year?
The
chemicals.
The same. 155.
Chemicals, 155K looks a bit high when one looks back on 141 average for 3 years. And the annualized rate through September is 120, so it looked a bit high, about 10-15K high to me.
But the chemical usage is pretty much based off of your flow and the loadings that go through the plant. Like this past month with all the extra rain, we had put through an extra 15 million gallons flow.
I know, but you had 141, you spent 141K average for the 3 years, 11, 12, and 13. And you analyzed through this year through 120, so you're looking for 155K. It looked to me like it was a bit high, Mike.
Like I said, it's one of those figures that will probably fluctuate throughout the year with the flow and then the loadings. Our loadings have been a little higher.
Is your PM system still in place?
Yes.
And how are you running yellows and greens and all that?
Good. We've been averaging between 15 to 25.
Okay. And the spare parts program is in place?
Yeah.
Okay. And all the metrics are still there?
Yeah.
Mike Carl. Okay. What's the sludge blanket of 8,000? What's that all that about?
We wanted to optimize our sludge readings for the tanks. It's like a probe that you would put into the tank, the clarifiers, to measure the depth of the sludge in each tank.
And you need a blanket? No.
Yeah, each tank will build a sludge blanket and then
cover the whole tank?
No, it's actually the sludge towards the bottom.
In the tank. Oh, build a blanket. Okay.
Yeah, so it'll actually monitor it. So we can keep better track of that.
Is that the first time we've done that, or what?
It's a new technology that they came out with.
When?
A few years ago.
Have you had it in your budget?
No, not last year.
This is a new entry, $8,000.
Yeah.
Nothing there in 11, 12, 13, 14. Now here comes $8,000 for a sludge blanket.
It's not for the sludge blanket. It's called the sludge judge, is it?
No, that's to manually do it. That's how we do it now. They have this automated thing that you put in there.
Oh, okay. You're saying you've got sludge in the bottom of your primary clarifiers.
Yes.
And you want to measure it accurately.
Yes.
Okay.
So we can trend that through our SCADA system.
All right, gotcha. Okay. I didn't know if you were trying to pull some kind of a blanket over the front.
Yeah, the cover to tank.
Pigs in a blanket kind of thing.
I said, I wouldn't want to be a part of that blanket. All right, what else we got here now? Stainless steel grit box. Talk to me about that. 40K.
Yeah, that's up at our septic site. We have just a regular steel box that we would scoop out the sand.
Oh, yeah. That's in that front building there where the water comes in.
No, it's up by the septic site where the septic haulers would offload or then the RVers would.
Okay.
So they rake out anything that gets caught in the grates, and then that goes in this box, which is outside to the elements.
I
actually got a picture of it right here, and you can see the whole bottom of it's all corroded.
Let me see.
It's a roll-off container.
Yeah.
Okay.
But we have a stainless steel version, one of these, in our headworks.
Yes.
And that thing's, it's like brand new still. And so I wanted to invest in one of these, so.
Well,
why not?
Looks like it's needed.
Yeah.
And what do you need with a cement mixer? This is a wastewater treatment plant.
Well, that's the sewer and drain
request.
You're
mixing a slurry together here?
That's the sewer and drain request.
Ah.
Which
they want to pour some concrete, put in a box, and stick me in it.
Cement shoes.
So that came in from...
No, that's to replace a 1991 cement mixer that we have.
And it's in your place?
Why no, it's in the sewer and drain.
Sewer and drain. They're part of the wastewater treatment plant.
Oh, okay. Part of that budget, that section of the budget.
So you're comfortable with the wastewater treatment plant today?
Yes.
That's all I have, Madam Chairman.
You good?
On the wastewater.
4320.
I'm quite familiar with the operation.
All right. Moving right along.
I'm all set.
Sonny?
I'm all set.
Brian?
Page 104. Overtime necessary response to Rye. Why don't we charge Rye?
We do. Okay. We get reimbursed.
So this is just
for
the
our time, yeah.
Cover till we get paid back,
yeah.
Type of thing?
Yeah.
We have about 15 pump stations, right?
I'm good. Thanks.
Mike.
Madam Chair, I'll yield my time to the Right Honorable Mr. Pierce, which seems very anxious to ask a question.
Well, she keeps skipping me because she thinks I'm taking a nap.
Well, I haven't forgotten
you,
Mr.
Pierce. No, Mike, you're in that corner, and then Jerry takes control. Blame Jerry.
Blame Jerry. Should I kick Jerry? Okay. I have a question about tipping fees. I thought they were connected to CPI or something. In other words, there was a certain rating.
That's true for the trash.
Okay.
Not necessary for sludge. This is for sludge.
So when you do sludge, does that change every year then?
It depends on a couple of factors. One is an environmental fee that is assessed to us, and I'm not sure exactly how they calculate that, but it's not just a matter of the CPA.
Really don't know what you're going to be paying next year until sometime late in the season?
Yeah, I think they let us know about September, October in that time frame.
Because I noticed it went up about 6% or something like that, and I didn't know if that was because... Probably don't have much of an increase in sludge, but probably an increase in the fees, tipping fees.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is.
We always see an increase to some extent in those
but
fees.
But it's not tied to, like, the one for the trashes. And
I think that's a component, but I think there's an additional component with an environmental fee that's an additional cost that we don't have for the solid waste.
And the only other question I had was about the one that Brian already asked, so that takes care of that one. And then... the only other thing I had was Jerry's pet with the gas and stuff, so I'm all set. Thank you, Madam Chairman. Thank you.
Bob?
How close to capacity are you at? Asking in another way, with the building that's now in the pipeline, will that affect capacity?
It depends on how you look at capacity. The state looks at, you could look at the total capacity of the plant at, say, 100% capacity. But the state starts getting nervous at 80%. If you get to 80% of your volume through your plant, the state would then put a moratorium because they don't want to wait until the last minute. But we just negotiated a new capacity, and I can't remember exactly what that was with Wright Pierce.
Yeah, it's 4.7 right now. That's
okay. 4.7 million gallons.
Million gallons a day.
What is the percentage capacity presently?
It's about 2.5, is it?
Yeah, our average flow.
About 2.5.
So we're not near the 80%? I mean, it was something complex.
Once we hit around 3.9.
What about seasonally in the summer? How close to capacity you come for the summer months?
Our capacity, the bigger issue with our capacity is the spikes that we would get. We get so much infiltration and inflow in our system that we have more spikes than actual... daily usage. So, but they average it out. They don't take those spikes here. So there may be a day that we may be nearing, the 4.7 million, but over a period of an averaging, we're okay. So
the current level of development, you're not concerned about?
Correct.
Okay. Thank you.
Back to tipping fees. Just to expand on what Mike said a little bit, we're talking here about the cost of taking this sludge and what?
Sludge.
Sludge and grit.
to Rochester.
To another facility. Well, first of all, you got to compress it, and is that what you were talking about?
Yeah, the sludge gets dewatered.
It's going to be dried out, right? Transported to where? Who do we pay that $218,000 to?
Waste management.
Some context.
Waste management takes it. Do they take it, or we have to deliver it?
We deliver it.
Deliver it.
With our own trucks and staff.
Turnkey?
Rochester, all right. All right, okay. I don't know who's getting the money.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Mike, one question. What's the water content of that? Are we still around 25% solid, 75% water?
Yeah, it's been coming out 26, 27s, and actually we're going through and demoing some new types of polymers.
Good. I'd like to see that up around 30 if we could get there.
Yeah, we've been averaging, if we're just doing straight primary, it's in the
high 30s. We're essentially hauling water. 75% of what we're hauling is water. Now, if we could dry it out through either centrifuge or infrared, that would be wonderful, except it would drive up electricity costs to beat the hell.
Yeah.
And so you're caught between. We're using the best press we can. But in order to dry that sludge out, there's only two methods that I'm aware of, centrifuge and infrared, and or just spread it all over the ground until it dries out with the sun. But centrifuge and infrared is just not very cost-effective because it utilizes a lot of electricity. As a matter of fact, although Hampton's lights probably dim. It's not up to centrifuge.
Why don't we spread that all over the ground,
okay,
like you suggest?
Are we done with discussion?
Can't do that.
Yes.
Okay. We have a motion. We have a second. I'm sorry. Do you got anything you'd like to add to that, Keith? I didn't mean to interrupt you. All right. We have a motion. We have a second. We have had our discussion.
Count 43-21 vote, right?
Did I leave anybody off over here? No. Okay. Somehow it drifted back over there. Michael. So everybody's good? Okay. All those in favor?
Yeah, that's right.
Opposed? Abstain. Please note, Steve left, so the counts on the votes will be different for the second half.
Right.
Thank you.